Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Texas. We just got a little bit of everything we're going to do today. We're going to do a little hay raking, probably a little baling, finish planting the corn, trying to get the equipment kind of back to the shop and get them all washed. And we'll see where we get to. So we're going to get in here and get this tractor started raking. Just turn, put him back on his course to go in here. Well, thought we might. So this is field 4. Put him on rakes. Okay. So let's make sure he's got... Looks like he is on the right path. I don't understand these guys sometimes. Let's see if he'll start right here. There we go, he's acting right now. Alright, let's go to his partner here. So it looks like he's working right. So we'll just let them guys go till they get everything raked up here. We're gonna go down here to 13. We're going down here to 13. Get these guys started. Let's see. Is that right? I think it is. Don't know where the start and stop is. Let's see here. He must be pretty close to being at it. Alright. So we're just gonna first waypoint, see where he goes. Oops. Didn't need a buddy here. So we're on 13, 4 mocos. Okay. Alrighty. Let's start him at the first waypoint. Buddy come by here where he gets a little bit of distance between them. So this should be the first one to the right. Yes, sir. All So we're just waiting on that guy to get over there and get a little distance between them. Just let him get to the corner and we'll send this guy off. Do the same thing, let these guys get kind of spaced out, go from there. Bought a little bit of new equipment, bought a new combine, a couple of corn headers, beans. We've got nearly everything in corn. Bought a Krone Big X580 and a Krone Cargo so we can start chaffing stuff. See if we can get our BGA going. See how that works out for us. Make us a little money. Alright. Send you on your way. Just kind of watch this guy here a minute. I know he's going the right way. Watch him over here. He'll get over here and start and take off again. Have an overview of him. Kind of odd that we're just showing three. Should be showing four. Don't show that first John Deere for some reason. This guy will get out here and turn the corner. So there's one in front of him. There's one in front of him. So we're going to call these guys good. We're going to go. Maybe we're sprayer. I had to spray all these fields. I did that while y'all was gone. With our little 4940 John Deere sprayer. Works good. I'm going to go down here and fill him up before we park him. So I'll pay attention to where I'm going. I'll just park him here in one of these stalls. There we go. I about hit the head on the barn. Pretty tall piece of equipment. Alright, let's go to our, well, here's one of our four-wheel drive John Deere's we bought last time. And our DB90 planter. We'll take him back to the barn. Maybe wash him a little bit. Planting the rest of corn. I'm gonna go ahead and set time up here where it goes a little faster. Just a little bit anyway. It's not a whole lot, but it'll keep it moving right along. It might get dark on us before we get done. If it gets too dark, we'll just speed time through it there for a minute. Or I'll pause the video and get through it or something. We'll make it all work. Gonna have lots of corn, lots of silage, I know that. These planters, they must not get dirty. Just the tractor and the planter started at the same time, and the tractor got real dirty and the planter didn't get dirty at all. We might get into animals here one of these days. We're just gonna leave this right here, and we'll go ahead and spray it off. Get it all cleaned up and get ready to do something else. Good. Just park him right over here. Alright, we're going to jump to our other John Deere and we're going to do a little planting. All everybody else's is raking the grass, mowing the grass, and all that. We'll just do a little planting. See if we get this cornfield finished up. It's pretty good sized fields. Drive from inside the tractor for a while. We kind of got a spot there where we need to be looking. I don't know what that is, but anyway, don't look so big man here, but it is pretty good size. Something popped up there in traffic. I don't know what it was. I didn't think there'd be anything that close together. Maybe them rakes, but I wouldn't think so. But there's going to be a lot of corn. Make a big sale this time. Depends on how fast the silage cutting goes. I might end up putting 1 in 12. See how much bunkers the 12 fills up. 10 is closer than 1, so I don't know. We'll probably put 2 fields in silage. See how that works for us. Well, something's already finished. Must be one of those rakes. Shouldn't be too far behind him finishing up. So we get this done, we'll go down there and start one baler baling, and then we'll drive the other baler. Just kind of get this miscellaneous work done. It's all got to be done. Sometimes I do it off screen. I thought maybe y'all enjoy seeing a variety of different things other than just harvesting. Cultivating. I know I start cultivating or start planting and I do a lot of it off screen, so we'll just run along here. It's not going to take too long to get this planted as big as this planter is. So we'll just work along here. See if we can get this planted, and then we'll go down where those rakes are. Back down field 4 and do some baling. Yeah, the second one must be done. He pulls up there behind the other one and stops. He thinks he's in traffic because he can't get back to where he's supposed to be, or where he thinks he's supposed to be. We'll just go check on these guys. I know that's what they're doing. This guy, he's done. Yeah, see the other guy, he wants to be in this spot. That's all right though. See, as soon as we move, he'll say, oh, that's where I want to be. And now it says he's finished. So we'll just get him off the field where he don't keep showing us that he's busy waiting on somebody. I'll go back and finish planting.
Whoops.
Get the button happy here. Get to mashing the wrong button to get off on the wrong things. So, I'm going to do this. I'm going to turn the seer on and go. I think about the only equipment I haven't bought that I wanted to buy was the auger wagons. I'm not sure. I might buy the Kinseys and see if these articulated tractors will pull them. I think I've seen different videos where they don't do a very good job just because they have to get up beside the tractor and Ben's. Well, Ben's got the corn headers on. The augers are actually very long on the combines anyway, so it might be okay. We'll just have to set it up. I guess we could put our row marker out. The thing is, the camera don't go out far enough to see where the row marker's marking. Definitely marking. Just like three fields, I think, buying everything. We're not going to buy 7 and 13 because it's just grass. That's what we're using them for. And 5, 6, and 9 is all we like buying, so we'll get them bought probably this go around. And we'll probably make a round on everything, planting everything and harvesting and some more equipment just to see. And we might start looking for a different map. I'd like to find one where we do cotton and sorghum, a whole lot more fruits than what we've done here. Stay in the tractor. So it's just going to take this pass and one more. I don't know. This one more to piece, probably. What's our tractors look like down on 13? They're still making rounds. Pretty good. Can you even see the row marker? Yeah, you can kind of see it there. Must be where I turned it on. I went past it there. So that's halfway to the next one. Yeah, maybe almost two full ones. And you can see down there where the... Yeah, I'll do this to get the mouse. Right out here, you can see where the tractor's working when rolling stuff up. Looks good. Can you see back over there? No. It's too far away. A couple more passes, we're going to have this. With the baling hay. Something a little bit different. But I think the biggest part of the time I baled hay off screen, just hauled a little bit of it with y'all. So So we'll put one tractor to work and we'll bail the rest of the end of the episode. See that ridge marker in the air. I need to work on just a little bit more to get it to ride the top of the ground out there. It's still pretty good. Pretty good mod. Let's see if you can see these things right here. Well, almost. If we can get off, walk around here, you could. Pretty good job on them. They just fix them where they get dirty. Kind of like them getting dirty, spray them off every once in a while. We get this back to the barn, and Ben's auger wagon's the only thing I hadn't bought. Offloaders, overloaders. Well, look at the price difference between the red ones I've been using and the Kinsey's. See how much price difference there is in them. We might go ahead and get the Kinsey's, or we might have to wait till we sell some hay. Because I'm thinking they're $70,000 or $80,000 a piece. See what it says it's supposed to take to corn. $3,742. About 90,000 corn. That's a lot of corn. 22 hectares. I think about a hectare is about a half an acre, I think. I'd have to look it up. So I think 13 is our biggest field. It's not on here because I haven't bought it. Tile's pretty good size. It's 21. The same as this, 21.52. Oh, 22. It's actually bigger than 12. Oh, wow. Okay. So this must be the next to the biggest. Let's 7's pretty good size. I don't think it's as big as 1. 13 is by far the biggest. And we're getting right down to the end. Let's have all the corn planted. Gets back to the farm, Marshall tractor, and put it up. Now we're going to bale in some hay. Him in here by the other one. We'll skip working the tractor and get that later. Just leave him right there. Let's jump down here at these balers. Right here. So this is, we'll use the same one that we just used for the rakes. And he ought to be on the left. And the one I'm gonna drive will be on the right, but we won't need him. So we're gonna send him to the first waypoint. Let him take off. I'm gonna pick up this little bit of stuff right through here. One of the tractors left. It's a whole lot quieter inside the cab. It's kind of funny, it gets dirty inside the cab. We'll just bale some hay here. Seems to be a pretty good cash crop. For some reason I'm catching out of the guy, seems like. He slows down more at the corners than I do. I'll watch up here and see. Oh yeah, he slows down way down when I don't slow down at all. I'm just gonna whip it around there. Pretty good size areas them tractors miss. I don't know why. And mowers. Seem like they do a real good job on some fields, and some fields they miss quite a bit. Can need to rake these corners out. Next time, I guess. Passing on this corner, looks like. We're getting real close. We're not side by side here. Sure enough. Of course, I'm going a lot shorter distance, or a little shorter distance than he is. But he slows down a lot more than I do. Well, folks, we've run right up about the time we usually try to make the videos, the length of them. So I'm going to finish baling this hay and probably sell all of it. I'll probably let y'all watch some of the baler, the raking and baling and selling on 13. But I'm going to go ahead and finish baling this and probably haul it, sell it, and get those Kinseys bought so we can use them in our big harvest. And probably go ahead and speed time up and get that corn up where it's ready. And probably go from there. So, if y'all enjoyed the video, hit that like button. If you just happen by and like what we're doing, hit the subscribe. Leave me a comment down there. And we'll catch y'all next time. Y'all have fun. Talk to y'all later. Bye for now.